Hello, my lovelies. Welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, hi, my name's Jakara, and today I'm going to be talking about 10 Mother's Day ideas for this upcoming Mother's Day. Talk to me nice, talk to me honestly. Okay, so I have broken down this list into categories. There's the practical, the luxury, and then there's a random category that will include all kinds of things. But first, I want to start with the practical because everybody's mother is not the same, obviously. You know, some mothers like practical gifts, some mothers like luxurious gifts, some mothers like gifts related to their hobbies and, you know, their interests. So, I am a mother who likes practical gifts because I always buy myself the non-practical stuff just because that's just how I am. That's my personality. But I love the practical stuff. It's probably stuff that I wouldn't necessarily look for or go for because I feel like, you know, I can cheap out on those things if I want to. But you know, for people who like practical gifts, I mean, there's a plethora of ideas. However, I just want to give a few ideas here that maybe your mother, if she is that type of person, that she would like. So the first thing I have on my list is bed sheets. Now, we use bed sheets every day, right? We sleep on our bed sheets. Yeah, we could get the cheapo versions from the, you know, the super stores like, you know, Target and Walmart and things like that. And those are fine. They work well. They last a while, you know. But why not upgrade your mother's sheets? You know, just find out what type of bed she has and buy some Pima cotton sheets. They don't have to be super high thread count or anything like that. But, you know, around the 300, 350 range would be nice. It's nice and soft. And Pima cotton is very soft. And then there are sheets that are like cooling sheets because, you know, at a certain age, I won't say what age that is, you know, we tend to have our own little furnaces, internal furnaces. And at night, you know, it can get really hot, especially with covers and things on top. So a cooling set of sheets would be great. I'm sure she would love you for it. I definitely appreciate my cooling sheets. And the next practical item that I have on my list is a gift certificate. Now, gift certificates fit everybody, right? You don't have to worry about size or, you know, you can just determine the amount that you want to give for the gift certificate, but not just any old gift certificate, but a gift certificate for a specific reason. So if someone gave me a gift certificate for, say, car maintenance, like oil changes or, you know, getting things, my service for my car, or if I got a gift certificate for, excuse me, for like lawn maintenance, somebody to come and cut my lawn, maintain my lawn, I would be so excited because first of all, I don't like cutting the lawn. I don't like mowing the lawn. And if you could have somebody who's going to do that for you, it definitely will take a lot of stress off your mom. And, you know, you have a beautiful lawn or your car is maintained and they'll think about you every time they use that service. So that's on my list for practical gift ideas. And then the last one is things related to her getting ready. So I put on this as an example, silk robe. As mothers, we tend to put ourselves last and we don't really think about like how we are dressing ourselves or how we walk around the house and what we're walking around the house in. I mean, if you see, I have some silk robes, let's just be clear. However, I know a lot of mothers that I know don't have anything nice like that. They walk around even a terry cloth robe, you don't have to go as high as a terry cloth robe. I mean, a silk robe. You don't have to spend that much money. But, you know, if you get a nice, soft robe or silk robe, I feel like silk is way more, you know, luxurious. And it, they'll think about you. It's a special item. And there's some that are so beautiful out there. They can be on the pricey side. But, again, this is something that your mother will cherish. And every time she wears it after she takes her shower, she'll really think about you and make sure she, you know, she's being wrapped in luxurious fabric. So just an idea. Now, the category of luxury. So this is my favorite category. Now, most of these items on the list are under $200. However, a few of these things on the luxury side are a little bit more. And the first one I have is a day spa visit. Now, I know someone who every Mother's Day, he would always give his mother a gift certificate for a day spa to go and do facials and massages and any other treatments that she decided she wanted to do. And I think that's another thing that as women or as mothers especially, we don't really pay attention to. We don't pay attention to our skin that much. I mean, some people are better than others about it. But when you have children and you're busy and you're tired and you're running around after your kids and everything, over time, you just start to, like I said before, put yourself last. And if your mother is the type of person who doesn't really think about those things, then this might be a nice surprise for her to say, hey, go pamper yourself, take care of yourself. I want you to, you know, love on yourself the way I love you. And I'm sure she will be surprised and she will probably love you for it because it's probably not something that she would necessarily pay for on her own. The next luxury item that I have on my list for Mother's Day is an overnight stay in a luxury hotel locally. So again, it's rare that we get to stay in hotels in our own hometown. And it's actually quite a unique experience. If you've ever had a staycation and you wanted to not just stay in the house, but stay in the area in which you live, it's always nice to be able to check out the local hotels. I know in Chicago, we have such beautiful hotels. And on my 50th birthday, I did an overnight stay at a luxury hotel downtown on Michigan Avenue. And that was such a treat for me. I loved it. It's something I didn't even think of doing before, but I treated myself to it. And it really was nice to have that kind of turn down service and the beautiful environment and the nice sheets and the nice bedding. And it was just a great experience. And I just know that most moms don't think about stuff like that. And maybe they've never been to one of those hotels and they would like to experience it. You know, you drive by it all the time and you're like, oh, that's such a nice hotel. I wonder what it looks like on the inside. I think your mom would appreciate just, you know, one night. It doesn't have to be, or you could do a weekend if you'd like, if, you know, give them a couple days, Saturday and Sunday. But yeah, just something different, something where they can take time out for themselves and really enjoy a new environment, something luxurious, something that someone thought they were special enough to receive. So just a thought. Then I have my random category. Now this is, I say random, but these are kind of more traditional things that people give their mothers for Mother's Day. But I'm just kind of like bumping it up a little bit, up a notch. Like I said before, elevate the other every day. So the first one is jewelry. Now, it's not uncommon to give moms jewelry for Mother's Day. But think about the jewelry you're going to give your mom. Is she someone who likes something blingy like I do? I love really blingy stuff. If you want to kind of give her something that's a little bit more elevated, that's blingy, check out the Swarovski store. And with the Swarovski crystals, I have purchased gifts there for people who love the sparkle. And I'm sure you'll find something that would suit her. They even have little figurines that, you know, people collect. But Swarovski is a great place to go. And don't let the name kind of intimidate you. They have things that are reasonably priced there. They really do. They have a whole price range to choose from. The other jewelry store I say to check out would be Pandora. Now, of course, Pandora is pretty popular. Everybody knows Pandora. But if your mom has a specific interest or a specific hobby that she's into, you can customize a bracelet based on that hobby or interest. Like, for instance, this is my Pandora, one of my Pandora bracelets. I have another one, but this one is all about my travels. So as I travel around the world, I just collect little mementos, little pendants. This is the Eiffel Tower. I have a Jamaican flag, heart. I have a koala bear, things like that. So it's specific to my interests, and so every time she looks at it, she knows that she can add another piece to it. And you know, these little pieces don't cost a whole lot. I mean, they can be, depending on what the piece is, they can be on the higher end, but most of the time they're reasonable. And or you could just start her out with the bracelet, and then she can add the pendants as she goes along. I think this is a great idea. I did give my mom a Pandora bracelet and some charms to go on it. So, and every time I go somewhere, I also get her a charm as well. So we both love travel. So I add that to her bracelet as well as my own. Now the next one is perfume. Now perfume is very subjective. Everybody doesn't like the same perfume. However, there are certain ones that are pretty popular among certain age groups. And if you just got to do a little research to see, you know, whether your mom would be interested in certain types of notes in a perfume. I personally love fruity, citrus, sometimes fresh, sometimes floral. It depends. I love amber notes and musky notes, but a little sweetness. But not everybody likes this. Some people like a clean, fresh scent. Some people like more woodsy tones. So you can always talk to your mom about that, like, you know, or even just check out what perfume she has on her vanity or in her bedroom, and you can just kind of compare. So if you know she likes Victor and Ralph Flower Bomb, just go on the website, go on the internet and compare and contrast, see what other fragrances would she most likely enjoy based on her liking that particular fragrance. And that's a pretty easy thing to do. And, you know, some people, my mom doesn't, she's allergic to perfume, so I can't get her any perfume. So that's out for me. But if you have a mom who wears perfume, that's an idea, right? And then the next one is kind of really random, but there are certain moms who love tea or coffee. I'm one of them. So as you can see, this list is kind of based on my interests, but I'm sure there are other moms who also share these interests. Coffee connoisseurs, tea connoisseurs. I love tea. I love coffee. And if someone was to give me a specialty tea or a specialty coffee, something I can't get in the grocery store, right? Something that comes in either a nice package, smells really aromatic. You can go to those specialty tea stores or specialty coffee places, and they could recommend something for you based on kind of what your mom normally would drink. Lastly on my list, I have bulbs or starter kits for seedlings. If your mom is into gardening or nature, it doesn't have to be something like super, you know, involved. It could just be a few bulbs, like a few peony bulbs or a few dahlia bulbs or whatever flower that is her favorite flower. You could give it to her in the small version and then help her to learn how to grow it if she's interested in that, or seedlings if she likes. For instance, I like tomatoes, so if somebody gave me a packet of heirloom tomato seeds, I'd be so, you know, grateful. And even if you have, they have those little starter packs, you can get them on Amazon or you can go to the local home and garden center and they have the little starter pack that has the kind of greenhouse with it. It's really nice. I've used it. Very easy to use. It's fun to do, a fun activity, and just something to watch over time, something that she can get excited about. And then at some point she'll reap the fruits of her labor, literally. So, I mean, those are just some ideas that you can use to kind of figure out what it is your mom would like for Mother's Day. You know, I personally don't need a gift for Mother's Day. I'm like, being a mom is a gift. It's a blessing. I know that sounds cliche and corny, but it is true. I love my daughter so much, and she has changed the trajectory of my life, and only for the good. And she's taught me so many lessons. I love her to death. She is my roommate. And my daughter is grown up now, but she is grown into such a beautiful woman. And I am so proud of her. And I love being her mom. I'm so proud to be her mom. And I love my mother as well. I'm very much a mommy's girl. And she's the hardest person to buy things for. That's why I created this list, because I was like, well, what can I get her this year that she might appreciate? So, you know, if you have a mom like that, which she's difficult to buy for, then maybe some of these ideas might help you. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed the video, you guys. I really do. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. I would love to see you back here for my next video. And if you can, I would love to have you subscribe and be part of our family. If you can just click the subscribe button and the notification bell so you know when I upload my next video. You guys, we are growing. I'm hoping to get 2 subscribers per video. So hopefully by the end of the year, maybe we'll get to my goal of 500 subscribers so that I can have a community page so I can make announcements and do giveaways and things like that for you guys. So if you would be so kind as to click the subscribe button to help us out with that goal, that would be awesome. In the meantime, I hope you have a great day or night wherever you are. And I will see you in the next video. Until then, take care.